These are plot spoilers for the Scarlet Letter, chapters 5 through 8. Chapter 5. Hester is released from prison, and now she has to figure out how to live with the shame of her sin. She lives with her baby daughter in a house outside of town, and makes a living by doing sewing work for the townspeople. While not much happens in this chapter, you should look for what it says about Hester and about how the A affects her relationship with the rest of the community. Chapter 6. The name of Hester's daughter is Pearl. Is her name symbolic? You bet your sweet romanticism it is. See if you can find out why her mother named her this. Pearl can be a challenging kid, to say the least. She doesn't care for rules, and the townspeople see this as the result of her being born out of adultery. Look for how Pearl is described, literally and figuratively, and see what conclusions you draw about what kind of person she is. Chapter 7. We see more of Pearl here, including the beautiful red and gold trimmed dress her mother has made her. Now, where have we seen something in red with gold trim before? That seems symbolic. Because of the wickedness they see in Pearl, the Puritan townspeople think it might be best for everyone if they remove the child from her mother. Hester goes to the governor's house to deliver gloves she's made for him, but her real purpose is to plead for them to not take her daughter away. Outside the governor's mansion, Pearl admires the sunlight and asks her mom for a rose, and Hester says some stuff that makes it all sound very symbolic of something. Chapter 8. Inside the governor's house, Hester pleads her case, arguing that Pearl keeps her from descending deeper into sin. Reverend Dimmesdale backs her up and thinks it will do them both good to leave the girl with her mom. Meanwhile, Pearl does and says a lot of things that someone looking for symbolism could read a lot into. At times, she's compared to a bird, a rose, and an elf. See what you make of all this. In the end, the men decide to let Hester keep Pearl. As she's leaving, the governor's sister, a literal witch apparently, invites Hester to meet the devil with her in the woods. Hester says that she might have, but she's got this kid to take care of, so no thanks.